Hi, this is Kavita Suresh Kumar, and in this video I'm going to demonstrate how to create, modify and delete a VM instance in GCP using Terraform. I have logged into my GCP account. First, we need to create a service account. IAM. Click service accounts. Create service account. So let's give it a name as Terraform. Click create and continue. Select the role. So we need to provide the compute admin role because we are going to create, modify and delete a VM. Click continue. Click done. So now we have created a new service account. So let's create a key. Manage keys. Click add key. Create new key. Click create. Let's save the key as keys.json. So now we have successfully created a new service account and downloaded the keys.json file. So let's copy this project ID. I'm going to use Visual Studio Code Editor for adding the Terraform files. We need Terraform in our system, so I have already installed Terraform, so let's confirm that. I have the Terraform version 1.4.4 already installed in my system. Now let us add the Terraform files. First I am going to add the providers.tf file. All the Terraform files should have their extension as .tf. First I am going to add Terraform. I am going to add as a required providers. So the provider is going to be Google here. Then we need to provide the source. Source is going to be HashiCorp Google. Then we'll provide the version. Version is going to be greater than 4.60. So we have added the Terraform. Now let's add the provider. Provider name is Google. So we need to provide the project. So let's paste the project ID which we copied. Then let's give the region US test 4. Now we need to add the credentials. So we have the keys.json file here. So let's provide that. So let's save this provider.tf file. Let's add the variables.tf file. So here we are going to add a variable instance name. So we need to provide the description, instance name, and then we are going to provide the type. Type is string. Then we are going to provide the default value. Default is web server. So we have created the variables.tf file. Let's save this. So now let's add main.tf file. So here we are going to provide the resource definition. So we are going to create a Google compute instance and we will give the name is web server. So the resource type and the name will be used to identify this resource. So here we need to provide the name. So already we have created a variable, so let's use that. And the machine type, so we'll use E2-micro. Then we need to provide the zone, so US West 4B. So now we need to provide the boot disk. So we need to provide initialize params. Let's give the image. So we are going to give them images debian cloud / debian 11. So next we need to provide the network interface network. So we will provide use the default network interface. So we have successfully created the resource also. Let's save this. So now let's add one more file, outputs.tf. So this is for getting the output once the instance is created. So we will get the instance ID as the output. So we need to give the description. Instance ID, and then we'll give the value. Value is Google web server dot instance ID. Let's save this. Now we have created all the necessary files. First, let's do a Terraform init. It is installing the HashiCorp Google version 4.60.2. Terraform init is successful. The Terraform format command, it formats the Terraform files. Now you can see it has formatted the output.tf file. Now let us validate the Terraform files. So the validation is also successful. So now let's execute the Terraform plan. So the Terraform plan creates the execution plan, which indicates like what are the resources will be created when we do a Terraform apply. Here you can see it says it is going to create the Google Compute Instance web server. So the plus sign indicates the resource is going to get created. And here it says plan 1 to add, 0 to change, and 0 to destroy. Now let's do a Terraform apply. So again, this also has created the plan and we need to provide the approval. Let's provide the approval. It is creating the web server instance. And it has successfully created the web server, and you can see the output, the instance ID also. Let's go and validate computing GPM instances. So we can clearly see there is a new instance has been created, web server in the zone US West 4B. Okay, so now let us go back and let's do some change to the main.tf. So let's in, we want now the instance to be moved to US West 4C. So let's save this configuration, and then again we will do a Terraform apply. So you can clearly see it has again created a plan, so which says this instance has to be replaced because we want it in a different zone, so the existing instance cannot be updated. So that's why you see minus and plus. So now let's provide the approval, and also Terraform uses the terraform.tf state file, so which has the information about the existing environment, and this is what it compares with the new configuration and creates a plan whether the instance has to be replaced, created, deleted. All this information it gets by comparing with the current state which is available in the TF state. So now it is destroying the existing instance. Now it has successfully deleted the previous instance and it is creating the new instance. So now it has successfully created a new instance. Let's go and validate that. Now we can see there is a new instance which is in the zone US West 4C. Okay, so we have seen how to create and how to modify, and now let's do a Terraform destroy. Using Terraform destroy, we are going to delete the instances which we have created. So again, it has created a Terraform plan which says it is going to destroy this instance. So you see hyphen here, it's minus, it is removing the instance. So let's provide the approval. So it is destroying the instance. Now the instance has been successfully deleted, destroyed, resources 1 destroyed. Let's go and validate that. So that instance which we created earlier has been successfully deleted. In this demo, we have seen how to create, modify, and delete a VM instance in GCP. Thanks for watching the demo.